Welcome to our school. Bosany Primary School is a medium-sized school in Slovakia. It is attended by over 350 pupils. It was rainy day when we made this video for you, but it doesn't rain very often in our country. Pupils usually walk to school. Some of them are late, so they need to run. Some ride a bike and some are taken to school by their parents. At first, we have to put our slippers on in the changing room. Then we go to the classroom to get ready for the day's lessons. There are 18 classes at our school with about 20 pupils in each class. Our teachers and non-pedagogical staff are also getting ready for the lessons.
When music is played on the school radio, everybody knows that the lessons are about to start. Some pupils go to specialized classrooms. There are two computer labs with 36 computers in our school. And what is going on in a computer lab during a day? Let's have a look. Pupils in class 9A are making a project about Bratislava, the capital city of Slovakia. Seven B are writing some formulas in the Microsoft Excel program. 8B is learning how to work with an education program. The first graders are matching the pictures to the letters. Pupils in 5B are solving a math task and comparing their results with the computer. This computer lab is brand new, and class 6A is having a math lesson here. Here we are in class 1B. These pupils are our youngest. They are learning the alphabet letters and modern technology seems to be quite useful to them. As you can see, they are going well.
Ako sa nám darí? Kto sa
nám
darí? Koľko máme percent zatiaľ?
100%.
No, zatiaľ sme veľmi šikovní. No, uvidíte, čo to tak bude aj ďalej. Na ďalšom obrázku Sanko. No, čo je to? Strúh, had, lo. Pravda, veď strúha, mena strúha, len, no, ja neviem. Prvé písmenko je, neťukaj tá strúha. Dobre. Dobre. No teda, pozrite sa, Filomena jajka.
Čemu smrdí fajka?
No, takže čo je na obrázku, Adam?
Fajka.
Fajka, poď. A to je písmenko, ktoré sme sa ešte neučili, takže to bude ťažké, uvidíme. No, dobre.
This is class 1A. The pupils are learning to read and Mrs. Teacher seems to be happy with it.
The second lesson has just finished and it's time for a 20-minute break. Some pupils are going to the school buffet to buy a snack or lemonade. We love chocolate and biscuits. The more money we have, the more sweets we buy. Some of us are eating homemade snacks. They are tasty. Most pupils are relaxing, talking, or running in the school corridors. Oh, what's this? A fight? Don't worry, our teacher is here. These girls collect and exchange stickers. Hurry up, the lesson's about to continue.
Let's have a look at our language lab. We learn English here. This specialized classroom is occupied all day. We work with interactive whiteboard and our English teacher uses the document camera. We really enjoy using our laptops. We do lots of exercises and projects. At the end of the lessons, we put our laptops into the special box. It's a mobile charging station.
Welcome to class 7A. This class is very special for our school because of its participation in the Notebook for Every Pupil project. Each pupil has got their own laptop. It's great because pupils use their laptops at school and they are allowed to take them home after lessons. Pupils are learning English right now. They are divided into two groups and they are playing an English game on the interactive whiteboard. Yeah, English is fun. But now, be quiet and listen to Mrs. Teacher. She is going to teach you how to make an arrangement. This is a geometry lesson. Pupils are learning about reflection symmetry. They are using different tools from the interactive whiteboard's toolbar, such as ruler, protractor, and compass. Geometry wasn't very popular among pupils, but since they use the Cabri geometry software, they really enjoy these lessons. There is only one gym in our school, so sometimes pupils use school corridors for PE lessons. Pupils are playing dodgeball right now. This game is very popular among them. Players are divided into two teams and they try to hit their opponents with balls and avoid being hit. Pupils love this game. When it's warm enough, they have PE lessons outside. There is a football pitch, a volleyball court, a tennis court, a track, and a multifunctional playground behind our school. In our school, there isn't modern technology in each classroom. But when it's needed, pupils can learn in the multimedia classroom. This classroom is mostly used by our biology teacher. Pupils are learning about the plant body and the root structure. They are watching a video and using a tutorial, which is much more interactive than a book. However, sometimes it's good to carry out an experiment.
There are a few classrooms that are not equipped with technology. Teachers and pupils use chalk or markers to write on the board. At the moment, the children are having a music lesson. They usually listen to pop music and learn about famous composers. We like singing and playing musical instruments. This is an art classroom. We draw, paint, cut, paste, and use different materials. Then we put our work on the wall poster.
At the end of our school tour, we'll take a look at all these pupils. They are having a geography lesson and are learning about Japan. Maros is a smart boy. I think he will get the best mark. In our language, it's called jednotka.
Okay, Shikoku,
Dobre, ukáž mi Tokio.
Yeah.
Aké oceány obmývajú Japonsko?
Tichý oceán.
Aké moria?
Japonské more, Východočínske more.
Dobre, jednotka.
Kids, you have done a lot of work today. You must be hungry. Let's go to the school canteen. You deserve a delicious lunch. About 200 pupils have lunch in the school canteen every day. Our parents pay half the price of the lunch. The rest is paid by the state. Look at us. We really enjoy the meal.
After-school activities are quite popular among pupils. There are 20 different clubs and sports teams at school, which meet after the lessons are over. For example, dance club, ICT and video club, chess club, geography and biology club, football team, and others. A few pupils publish a school magazine called Sheep.
During the school year, there are lots of events for pupils, such as concerts, competitions, and meetings. Our latest event was a meeting with David Ogiga. It was great. We didn't want to let him go home.